Time to do some wrenching. I'm getting a howling out of this bearing, and I hit about 20 miles an hour. Anything over and it says howling, and it's getting kind of annoying. So I'm going to change it out and see what happens. If you got an impact wrench, you got to jack it up like I did and take this off. If not, you slow it down and take a breaker bar, get this center enough loose. Okay, I gotta get these brakes off. These are 13s, I believe. 13 millimeter. There. Now you get this bracket off. These are 15s. Got the brake shoes too. Yeah, this one goes like that. Bracket bolts are 15 millimeters. Take this center off all the way now. Okay, now
spray these up. With some penetrating fluid. Okay, I gotta take the little shield off too. I gotta look at it. Okay, it takes. These are 8 millimeters. Yeah. Going to reuse this ABS sensor because it works, still works, so I'm just going to use it. And they gave me one, but I'm just going to keep that one for a spare. By the way, I'll have a list of the tools I'm using and the parts and the specs, that what you torque it at. It'll all be at the bottom of the video. Okay, there's 3 bolts in the back that hold this bearing on, and they're torqued on there at 70 pounds, so there's another one. One more. Okay. Should come out. Yep. There she is. Okay. Okay, I'll clean this up a little bit. Get the new one. Does made in USA. You don't see that too often. Let's see if we can pick it up on the camera. It's right up on the top up here. Anyways, that's the baby. Put a little grease on these splines, not too much, just a little bit. Yeah, should be good. And goes like this. Put a little anti-seize on these. I had these off last year. They put a new lower ball joint in. And so they look like they still got stuff on them. But I'll put a little bit on them. It's hard to get started. Finally. Yeah, snug them all up. Then you gotta use a torque wrench on them. They gotta be at 70 foot-pounds. Okay. Let me get my torque wrench. Okay, the torque specs say 70 to 80 pounds, so I set this at 75 pounds. Here's the ABS sensor. Just clean it off. Clean it off a little bit in case there's anything on there. Goes right in like that. Uses the Allen screw. Why, but they got this Allen screw here. I don't know what size this is. I'll try to look it up, post it below. It doesn't have to be super tight because this is plastic and you don't want to break it. Just get it under kind of snug. Good enough. Okay. Now this dust cover. Which seems a pretty sorry shape, but these are little 8mm bolts. Snug, it's good enough. Okay. Put this on there and tighten that later. this nut here has to be torqued down to it's like 157 to 200, 200 and something, but my torque wrench only goes to 150, so it's gonna get 150 and maybe just a little extra, but that's it. Now the brake bracket goes on. Okay, it's the brake bracket. And there. Put a little bit of this stuff in here too, a little anti-seize. Okay. Snug it up. Good enough. The brake pads. Sometimes I think it's easier to do it this way. Put let's squeeze these in a little bit. Okay. Thank you. These really don't need it. These are 13. These are 13 millimeters. I just snug them up pretty good. You just go by a feel. You don't want them too tight. They're not very big bolts. Okay, that's good. Good enough. Now, just put the tire on and torque this nut down and. What I'll do is I'll tighten it up a little bit with this. Get the rest of the torque wrench. And okay. Get the wheel on. I like to get that stud up top straight, so it's easier to put the rim on. Now we'll let her down. Yeah. I gotta get those jack stands out of there. Thank you. Okay. Let me get my torque wrench set up.
For 150.
There.
Should be good. Okay, now I gotta
do the lug nuts. I'll check those out. Those are supposed to be 100. I'll back this off. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Should be at 100 right there. That impact wrench usually puts them pretty tight, so yeah, they're. They're good. Yep. Let's put this cover on. Like the video, give me a thumbs up.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe and hit the notification bell.